racing to the 2022 Breeders' Cup, and this time we go to the Spa, Saratoga. It is Whitney Week 2022. We've got the Grade 1 Whitney Stakes. This is traditionally one of the big dog stakes races on the year, right up there with the Pacific Classic, the Breeders' Cup Classic. You've got the Jockey Club Gold Cup, and that used to really be the preeminent championship race before the Breeders' Cup, but now it is the Whitney, mainly because of the handle on the race. You get the top older horses in the country pointing for this race, and this year it does feature a field of six. It's going to go Saturday, a mile and an eighth, and it is a Grade One, all part of a big card of racing that does include the Test Stakes. We've also got a look at the West Virginia Derby. That preview is already up. Let's take a look at this six-horse field. And interesting to note, Todd Pletcher has three of the six horses in this race. American Revolution is a Grade One winner. He won the Cigar Mile last year in 2021. He drew the rail in this spot. He's been running at Churchill Downs this year so far. And American Revolution has shown some speed, but he's also shown the ability to come a little bit off the pace. Now, Hot Rod Charlie has earned a lot of money in his career. He set the pace in the Belmont Stakes last year before begrudgingly losing that race in the final strides to Essential Quality. Zoomer is going way up in class. The former claimer is going to have to improve his speed figures by about 20 points to be competitive in this race. Olympiad, 5 for 5 for two in 2022. Got some pressure on the front end the last time out at Churchill Downs in the Stephen Foster. He's won at Gulfstream Park. He's won at Churchill Downs. He's also won at the Fairgrounds. Happy Saver closed in the mile, another big race for older horses. The winner of that race, Flightline, is pointing to the Pacific Classic. And then you've got Life is Good, the most likely favorite. He comes in off a victory in the John Nayrud after disappointing overseas in an earlier effort this year. He did win the Pegasus World Cup. That is a look at your six-horse field for the Whitney Stakes. Now let's start to take a look at some of the horses. I want to go over some of the big three contenders in this race, but the Whitney Stakes, a Grade One, a mile and an eighth, and if either Olympiad or Life is Good wins this race, they have a chance to maybe be Horse of the Year, along with a horse like Flightline and maybe Possibility, Jackie's Warrior. Those are the current leaders, I would say, for the Horse of the Year discussion, but still a lot of racing as we're only in the first week of August. Now, the top three horses in the betting are going to be Life is Good, Olympiad, and Hot Rod Charlie. I wanted to take a look at all three of those races, dissect their past performances, starting off with Life is Good. Life is Good comes in 7 for 9 lifetime. Now, he is 0 for 1 at Saratoga, and this is a horse, if you go all the way back to the beginning of his career, he drew off to a 9-length victory in his debut. His loss at Saratoga was to Jackie's Warrior off a long layoff. So I wouldn't hold that against him. It was probably one of his better races. He comes in off a 1:15 equibase speed figure. And Life is Good is by Into Mischief. Todd Pletcher trains, and probably his best race at a mile and an eighth was the Pegasus World Cup Invitational, where he beat Stiletto Boy and Nick's Go in that race. Meanwhile, Hot Rod Charlie, definitely one to consider. 4 for 16 lifetime on the win end, but he's got 5 seconds. He's earned over $5 million. In 2022, he's got a victory in the Al Maktoum Challenge. That was in Dubai. Then he ran second to Country Grammar in Dubai. And then last time out, second to Mind Control. You know, his best races, if you look, the Pennsylvania Derby and the Belmont Derby, he was closer to the pace and on the pace. Now, I'm not sure he has the raw speed, but if he is closer to that pace, that does soften up Life is Good a little bit. And the third of the big three in this race is Olympiad. He comes in 5-for-5 in 2022, 7-for-10 lifetime. He won the Stephen Foster. He won the Ali Sheba. He won the New Orleans Classic. And of course, he's by Spacetown. So, you know, a mile and a quarter, I'm not sure he can get that, but a mile and eighth should be in his wheelhouse. He does got some pace figures if he wants to use that speed to be up there early against Life is Good. Now, I see the pace shaping out like this. Life is Good setting a pace. I think the pace is going to be a little bit on the hot end. I don't think, even though we got a small field, all three of these horses can be forwardly placed. The pressers are going to be Olympiad and possibly Hot Rod Charlie. The closer is Happy Saver. Happy Saver would like a strong speed duel to develop to get his best chance of winning. He's been running in some big races, the Met Mile, the Ali Sheba Stakes. He won the Jockey Club Gold Cup a couple of years ago as a three-year-old defeating older horses. Now, my big questions coming into this race, how fast is the pace? I think the faster the pace favors a horse like even Life is Good because he can spread out that field a little bit, but it also favors Happy Saver as a potential runner. Does Hot Rod Charlie show more speed like he did in the Belmont and the Pennsylvania Derby? Will that soften up Life is Good? And then Olympiad, can he pressure Life is Good early so that Life is Good does not just run off the screen late in this race? Those are the big question marks. Even though it's a small field, again, you know, I think sometimes six horse fields and less, the best horse doesn't always win. But we do got some legitimate speed. Life is Good is going to be cranked to win this race, the Grade 1 Whitney. Olympiad could get Horse of the Year if he wins this race. And Hot Rod Charlie, a couple of tough losses for him. He gets back into that older horse discussion with a win here. My top selection is going to be Life is Good. I really think this is a good horse. I like his speed. I like the fact that he can rate. I like the fact that he's on the outside post. I'm going to play a straight exacta. Life is Good over Hot Rod Charlie and Happy Saver. If you want to go with Olympiad, there's nothing wrong with Olympiad. He's been running his race. And Hot Rod Charlie is probably going to be the third longest price of these three contenders. A very competitive Whitney. Who do you like in the Whitney Stakes? Leave a comment. Remember, the preview is up for the West Virginia Derby. We're going to the mountains this week. And who do you like in the Whitney Stakes as we get you ready for the 2022 Breeders' Cup?